noisy in here. But, so, this is my new car. If you follow me on Instagram, then you've known about it for a while. You've probably seen it a couple of times in pictures and stuff. You probably know that I've been working on it a little bit already. If not, then here it is. It's a 95 Acura Integra GSR. It's a stick shift, which you can't see, but yeah, my first stick shift car ever. Never driven stick before. I mean, I've screwed around a couple times, but never really daily driven a stick. So this is a learning experience, but it's going pretty well so far. So the things I've done to it so far, when I bought it, it was already lowered and on a certain type of coilover all around. It handles fantastically. It handles like Kyrie Irving. Anywho, so that's what was done to it before I got it. When I got it, the first thing I did was make it really dirty, because that's me. I've done a steering wheel. I put on an aftermarket steering wheel because those are dope, man. I also did a short shifter, which is great. It's a cheap one, so it probably won't last forever. I'll probably snap it eventually while I'm letting her rip somewhere. So that's okay. I expect it to. I paid like 25 bucks for it, and I mean, a skunk 2 is like, I don't know, 100 or something like that, something crazy for a little short shifter, and I'll probably end up doing that eventually. For now, I let the cheapness in me take over. It works. It works pretty good. It shifts pretty shortly. I've also done a aftermarket intake manifold, and for now, I've just taken like a 3-inch coupling, rubber coupling, clamped it on there, and then shoved a filter over that. So a Spectra air filter over that. That's my setup on the intake. It's really nothing that special, but down the road it will help me. And what I mean by that is my plans down the road, obviously we cannot let this sucker stay stocked. So she's going to be turb skied before too long. Hopefully in the next couple weeks. Now the way I work, when I say the next couple weeks, that could mean like 6 months. So we'll see. I really hope you can hear me. My one complaint about this car: I'm on the highway right now, doing 75, and we're almost at 4,500 RPMs, which is, for Honda guys, is probably like, yeah, that's normal, bro. For me personally, I've never driven a Honda engine car before. Like, I've driven them maybe once or twice, but never like every day on the highway. And so it's different. It doesn't feel natural. I'm used to cruising at like 1,500 to 1,700 RPMs in my old Firebird, which was way back, but you may remember that if you're a true fan. And then after that, I had the truck, which revved unusually high on the highway, cruised at like 3 grand, but that's still not as bad as 4,500 on the highway. And I know that's partially due to the GSRs have a shorter, or taller, I actually don't know how it works out, a shorter gear ratio in fifth gear, as opposed to like the LS version of the Integra, which would have a taller gear ratio, so that would bring it back. And I would consider that, but if this thing's going to be, if I'm going to take this thing to the drag strip, having that shorter gear might help me with acceleration on the top end. So once I've got the turbo and I'm making more power, then we'll see. That fifth gear might be too short, and I might run out of gear before I hit the end of the track. If that's if we're going very fast, because right now I think with the gear that's in it currently, the top speed is like 149 miles an hour. Which, so to pass that on a drag strip, you gotta have some beans under the hood, pretty much. So we'll see if I ever swap out that gear. I know it's not the worst job in the world, but I also know it's not very easy. bought myself one because, you know, I'm stupid. But 30 Mike Moto will be getting one soon. I've been saying that for about a year now. So I'll probably in the next year or two, I might buy a 30 Mike one. He bought me one of his shirts. Go check out 30 Mike for quality content and such. Pretty much, do you guys have any suggestions or things for me to do in the future? I don't really know a ton about Hondas. I've been doing some research ever since I wanted one of these, which has been for a while now. But so I know some stuff from my research, but I don't know a lot. So if you guys are hardcore Honda fans and you know some good upgrades that I might be interested in doing, please do let me know. Yeah, look for updates. See you soon. Thanks for watching. Leave a like if you're